Hello, I am Deep Thakkar, and today we will be teaching about arithmetic progression. Yes, arithmetic progression, AP. So let us see what is AP. AP means arithmetic progression. So this is the chapter 5 of our standard 10th. Yes, chapter 5. So first of all, let us see about arithmetic progression. That arithmetic progression means what? So let us see the definition of arithmetic progression. AP is a series of the numbers that decrease or increase by the same amount. So what is the exact meaning of the decreasing and increasing by the same amount? For that, we have two examples. Let us see that. The first example of the series is given to us, that is 1, 5, 9, and 13. As we can see here, the numbers are in the form of the increasing order, but not only the increasing order is enough to find out the series is in the form of AP or not. With the help of that, we need to find out here, the number must be increased by the same amount. Yes, the word same amount is very, very, very important. So let us see, 1 then 5, that means increased by 4. 5, then again increased by 4, that is 9. And again it is increased by 4, that will be 13. So the given series is increased by 4. So the given series is in the form of AP. Now let us see one more example. 11, 8, 5, 2. The given series is in the form of decreasing order. Yes. But the main important term is what? With the same amount. So let us see. It is decreased by 3. Again decreased by 3. Again it is decreased by 3. So the given series is decreased by 3. So yes, this series is also the part of the AP. So is it clear now that AP means if the given series is in the form of the increasing or decreasing order. But the main point is it should be in the same amount. So this is the main point of the AP. Now, let us see about the common difference. So what is the common difference D? Common difference D says that it is the difference between the two consecutive numbers. Suppose we have the series of an AP that is 1, 5, 9, and 13. Now see, between any two numbers, whatever the difference is there, that is known as the common difference. You can take any two terms. Yes, that is your choice. This is the first term. This one will be the second term. This is your third term. And this one will be your fourth term. We will find out the D with the help of any two consecutive terms and the difference between them, like A2 minus A1. So what is the A2? Second term is 5. And what is the first term? That is 1. That will be 4. Still, we can find out the D with the third and fourth term also. Yes, that is A4 minus A3. So what will be A4? 13. And A3 is 9. So that will be also 4. So for that, the formula of D, the standard formula of D can be written in this form, that is An minus 1. That is the formula of D, common difference. Yes. So now, this is the common difference. Now, with the help of common difference, if we need to find out the AN. Now, what is AN? This is the value of nth term of an AP. Yes, this is the value of nth term of an AP. The formula of AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, where A is representing the first term of an AP. N means number of terms and D means it is the common difference. So with the help of this formula, we can find out the value of nth term. So let us see one more example regarding this question, this formula. So let us see now the given, if the given AP is 10, 7, 4 and 1. So this is the first term, your A1 is equal to 10. Then the second term is equal to 7. the third term is equal to 4 and the fourth term is equal to 1. So what we need to find out? We need to find out first of all D. D means what? Common difference. So common difference is always there between any two consecutive terms. So we can start to find out the common difference with the help of A2 minus A1. So what is A2? What is the second term? 7. And A1 will be 10. So 7 minus 10 will be the common difference, that is equal to minus 3. So this is your D. This is the common difference. Now, let us see that. We need to find out one more thing, which is A7. Yes, A7. So what is A7? A7 means we need to find out the value of 7th term. Yes, we need to find out the value of 7th term. So what is your N? N will be 7. What is A? A means the first term, it is 10. And what will be your D? D is equal to minus 3. So we have all the datas, okay? We have all the datas that N, A, D is given to us, and we need to find out the A N, means A 7th term we need to find out. So remember the formula to find out the nth value of nth term, that is A N is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Yes, this is the formula. So now we need to place the value of each and every term. So let us see, what is your A? 10 plus N means 7 minus 1 and into D. D is what? It is minus 3. So now we need to simplify this. 10 as it is plus 7 minus 1, that will be your 6, and into minus 3 is there. So it is 10 now plus minus minus, and 6 into 3, that will be 18. So 10 minus 18 is equal to what? That will be minus 8. So your 7th term is equal to what? Minus 8. So as you have seen that the given AP is here, with the help of the AP, we can find out the common difference also. And if we need to find out the any number of term of the given AP, we can find out very easily with this formula. So this is the very important formula for the AP to find out the value of nth term. Hope this concept is very clear now for you. Okay. Thank you so much.